What is the deal, my YouTube family? It is your girl, Mary Monroe, and I am back here with another video. So, this is about to be really, really, really quick. I actually have something somewhere to go, so yeah. I was supposed to upload this yesterday, however, I was not able to, so I'm gonna just try to chop it down as quick as I can. I just want to reach out to my people that are on their spiritual journey. If you're not spiritual, I don't even want you watching me, for real, for real. But, you know, YouTube is YouTube, whatever. But this is for my specific people that are going down that path. You know what I'm saying? Understand that going through this process of evolving and constant change, you cannot pause on it. You cannot stop. It is inevitable. Change is inevitable. All of these things that are happening is for your development. It's for you to become your highest, your greatest version of yourself. And when a lot of people think of the greatest version, they usually just think like, you know, like what can you do to like succeed? It has a lot to do with that, but it also has like your greatest way of thinking. You know what I'm saying? Like the highest aspect of yourself. Getting to that level, you're going to lose people. You're going to feel alienated a lot. 9 times out of 10, you're going to grow up in a very broken home, a broken family. Listen, all of that is for a reason. You feel me? Because it's all a part of your evolvement. Yes, evolvement. Okay, I may have to make sure I said that right. But all I just want to say is just keep going down your path. It is okay to lose friends. It is okay to lose people in the process. It is okay. Okay, because being around people that I wouldn't say do the same thing you're doing, but understanding you and where you're coming from when you saying you are spiritual, just to say being around Christians, you feel me, or Muslims, whatever the case may be, being around these type of people is never going to mix. You know why? Because everybody is entitled to what they want to believe. But the thing is, What I'm in and what we are doing as a people, as a community, it is not a belief. If you are spiritual, then you know that it is the way of life. Okay? But what I see a lot of times on the internet is that spiritual people be trying to like, you know, just let it go. Let these people lead themselves into their own demise. Okay? You keep going down your path. Know that your spirit guides got you. Know that your angels are with you. Know that God is watching over you. And you cannot lose as long as you keep following your path. Okay? Period. And another thing I just want to say, like, it's going to be hard. Like, you're going to have to grieve. You're going to have to grieve. Especially when it comes to family members, you're going to have to grieve because it's inevitable. It's something that you cannot change. But you cannot sacrifice yourself and your self-development just because you want to be around people, just because you want to be there for people. Sometimes it's inevitable to happen. And you're going to have to go through that. You're going to have to go because it's all about transformation. And everybody not going to understand your transformation. People going to think you changed. People going to think you acting different. People going to think you fake. You got to be strong enough to keep going through it all. Through it all, okay? Okay? Period. Because at the end of this, and this is going to be going on for a while, but through the process, we are going to be the people who are going to survive. We're going to be the people who they're going to be running to and ask the questions. We are going to be them people. So use this time to gas up all your energy, to gather up all your energy, because you're going to need it. In these end times, we're going to thrive. Talking about planting food. Talking about getting in the sun. Okay? Meditating. Healing from your trauma. What? We are winners out here. Okay? Period. Like, this journey, it's amazing. And it is inevitable. people think like, oh, you're not supposed to open your third eye. You're not supposed to do this. You're not supposed to meditate. Baby, it's not about doing it. It's about opening up to what the truth is and knowing how to heal yourself from your past trauma. Learning how to unravel all of these belief systems that was cramped up in your head, okay? It is about freeing your mind. They think to free your mind is to be out of your mind. These people think that we out of our mind because we're not trapped in our mind. We're not trapped in our mind. We don't have limited beliefs. Okay? We're not trapped. We're not stuck up in illusions. Okay? And in this lifetime, understand that it's also not meant for everybody to wake up. Like here, what I'm doing here right now, it's either people gonna hear me out, they gonna understand me, or they just don't look at me like I'm out of my mind and I'm crazy. But like I said, everybody is not gonna wake up in this lifetime. All right? And to sum all of that up, I did what I had to do, said what I had to say. Mia Monroe signing out. Y'all have a blessed, wonderful day. Like I said, if you're going down this spiritual journey, just understand that it is not a walk in the park. It is going to be constant change. It's going to be constant challenges. It's going to be some things that is going to put you down when you're doing shadow work. It's going to be feelings coming up, that things that hurt you and all type of stuff. But once you heal from these things, once you keep growing and healing and just keep evolving yourself, and when you go through these challenges, just try to make the best decision possible and keep working on yourself. And I promise you're going to come out a champion. God will not let these things that's coming in this earth touch you. You won't be touched. Okay? When you got ancestors by your side, all of that stuff, if you think that is evil, you are too far gone. Period. Period. Us type of people, we know how to live without the internet. We know how to live without having a bridge card. Okay? You know why? Because we've been practicing on it. We knew what was to come in these times. Okay? Now I'm ranting off again, but it's just like, man, I done had people say I was a witch, called me evil, all type of stuff. But it's just like, I'm like, I could never be evil for changing my life and helping myself, helping other people. I could never be evil for that. Period. Period. Okay? I am a divine Piscean woman. Period. The divine feminine. Okay? Now, let me just sign up off of here. Like I said, keep doing y'all. And if it can't flow, let it go. If they can't listen to you, if they ain't got no open mind, get these people from around you. Let them go. Let them go. Okay? Peace out, y'all. I love y'all.